Hello everyone. So today we'll see how we can get the best out of the mutual funds and how do we research on what the mutual fund people are buying. So let me start with the web.stockage.com. This is one of the best website to research on mutual funds. And going to the top most mutual fund, this is my favorite, the Quant Small Cap Fund. I had invested in this fund 1 year back. And if you see the performance or the how much the fund has given, it has given 200% return in just 1 year. That means if you have invested 1 lakh, your investment would be 100% return would yield you 2 lakh, and 200% return will yield you almost 3 lakh rupees in just 1 year. So you would have earned 2 lakh rupees extra if you had invested in this mutual fund. And what's the magic? So the magic is done by the fund manager. So these are the three fund managers who are managing the funds, Sanjeev Sharma, Vasav Sagal, and Ankit Pandey. And second magic is the holdings. So you can check the holdings here. What do you mean by holding is, if you give them 100 rupees, where do they buy? What do they buy? So let's analyze the holdings here. First one is, if you are giving them 100 rupees, they will invest 8.6 rupees into Stylam Industries, 6.2 rupees in Newland Lab, 5.1 rupees in Tata Steel Long, Tata Elxsi 5 rupees, 5 rupees in Fortis Healthcare. So this is their allocation. And if you see the percentage, the change, percentage change means what, and this value we can get it at the end of each month. So this value, I'm currently seeing the value of March, this is the value of April. So in April, this mutual fund has added 500% Hindustan Copper. So what does it mean is, they have bought in Hindustan Copper. And if you see the last month's valuation here, they have sold Newland Laboratories and Tata Steel Long Products. So these were the two shares that were present in the portfolio of the Quant Small Cap. However, in this particular month, they have sold both of them. And this is the top holding that we can see here. Now, what magic they do is, let's check the shares that they are having. First is Hindustan Copper. So if you see Hindustan Copper, today market crashed, so we don't need to see that. But if you see the 1 month return, Hindustan Copper had given 37% return. So, and this was on the top of their April holding. So it will be a huge positive for this fund. And if you see year-to-day return, it's almost 200% return. So that's the magic the Quant fund does. Second one is Fortis Healthcare. So Fortis Healthcare, again, if you see in just 1 month, it has given almost 17% return. So since it's in on the top most buying list of the fund, that's why this fund just gave the best returns it could have. And why do they buy what they buy? This is the main question that you should ask. And once you learn that thing, you can get even more return than this particular mutual fund. So now, putting the question, why did he buy, the fund manager buy Hindustan Copper? For that, you just need to go to Google and type in copper price and search for the news. And you will see copper hits all time high. Okay, so this is a website wherein it shows that copper has hit all time high. And all time high in the sense, this is the price that is never seen till date. Now, if Hindustan Copper is selling copper, then it will realize more gains. So that's the reason he, this fund manager knew this thing from his experience. So that's why he has bought in Hindustan Copper. Second one is Fortis Healthcare. Why? Because everyone knows due to Corona, the demand of healthcare and products, related products is increasing. So the revenue is going to rise. Similarly, all of these stocks, they have some or the other plus points. And the best part of this mutual fund is they change the portfolio every month. How are they able to change? Because their asset under management, if you see, it's only 268 crores. So they can change the stocks, the full, all the holdings. I mean, they can sell all the stocks and they can buy all the new stocks. So what this fund manager typically does is he buys a set of stocks for 1 month, just churns out the returns. Let's say if the stock is performing 30-35%, he sells it and he buys another new stock. And now the question comes into the mind, why don't we buy these stocks that this fund manager is buying? Because if you see this data, it is of April, and we get the data at the end of the month. So right now it could be possible that it's let's say May, so they should have sold Hindustan Copper as well. To give you an example, in March the second holding was Newland Laboratories. If you see Newland Labs share price today, it got hammered. Yeah, so Newland Laboratory, it hit -10% today. It's a huge fall. But what we can see here is this fund manager has already sold the Newland Laboratories. So he has the grip on what is the direction of the market. So that's a reason why Quant Fund has functioned so well during the last 1 year, and it's the highest return giving fund. Similarly, let's see Quant Active Fund. This is also one of my favorite fund, wherein if you see the holding analysis, what does it have? I think there is some issue with the data. Yeah, so this is just a brief on how to spot a mutual fund and how to spot the stocks. Let's see an interesting fund called as Parag Parikh Flexi Cap Fund. So what happens with this Flexi Cap Fund is, so in the Flexi Cap Fund, they have their investment in international markets. So if you see here, if you give them 100 rupees, they are investing 8 rupees in ITC, 7 rupees in Bajaj Holdings, and so these are the stocks as discussed. Now, if you, I think in other assets, they'll be showing the international investments as well. So they invest in Google, they invest in Facebook. So this is the one of the mutual funds which invests in the overseas equities. So if you see here, it has allocated 8% to Alphabet, which is Google, 8% into Microsoft, Facebook 6%, Amazon. So all the top companies of the US market has been invested. So this is a country-wise diversification, wherein they also have Indian equities and US equities. So in case Indian market goes down, US market, Google will take care of your portfolio. So this is one of the best mutual funds in terms of diversification. It will give you an opportunity to invest in the US market as well. So there are a lot of mutual funds. If you see the AMCs, AMCs are asset management companies. So next time if someone says, I have invested in Aditya Birla Fund, so just ask them what is the scheme name. So there are 126 names under Aditya Birla Mutual Fund, but you have to find out what is the scheme. Is it small cap, mid cap, large cap? And the first fund that we showed you, that was the Quant Fund. It is very small. It is having an asset under management. That means investors have given them 1200 crores total. And if you see biggest, that is SBI Mutual Fund, they have 5 lakh crores. So that's the difference between the two of them. But Quant Mutual Fund has the good ability to churn his portfolio because it's small, so they can easily buy and sell the mutual funds. Now, coming back to the mutual funds, just see the top mutual funds, because seeing at the top mutual funds, you can learn what these fund managers have inside them or what these fund managers do to get the best returns. So let us go my returns. Yeah, I think there's a issue. Yeah, so there was also a fund called Quant. Yeah, I think we can go with the classes. So next, if you see the stocks that are going to rise as per the research, as per our research, is public sector banks for next 1 or 2 months. So the fund managers who are buying these particular banks, the government banks at least, they will be the best to get the returns. So it may be possible that Quant Fund would have bought this Punjab National Bank, as well as if you see Central Bank, I think it has hit 7% up today. So it was a weak market, and this Nifty went down by almost 150 points, but still the PSU banks were up by 5 to 10%. So coming back to classes, these are the classes of mutual fund. I am particularly interested in, I am not at all interested in large cap fund, because these are the least in, least return giving funds. Best returns would be provided by small cap fund in case of rising markets. Also, there are tax saver funds and sector funds. So let's discuss about the sector funds. My favorite sector fund is banking fund, because it's a predictable field wherein if banks are doing good, you will get a good return. So if you see the returns, 1 year return would be 86% with Nippon India Banking Fund. Banking fund is simple. They just invest in banks. That's it. I mean, nothing to discuss about. But let's see about one of the small cap fund. So return wise, if you see in 1 year, Quant Small Cap Fund has given 200%. And second mutual fund is Kotak Small Cap Fund, which has 128%. It's a huge gap, almost 70% difference between the fund returns. Let's open Kotak's mindset. What does it buy and why did it buy? So first one is Century Ply. It's again plywood company. I don't know this why this person has bought it, but it's due to the furniture. I mean, they anticipate that the demand of furniture and ply would be increasing. So that's their first holding. Second is Sheela Foam. Again, it's a consumer based stock that they have bought. So nothing interesting here. Sundaram, again, they do a good job, but again, due to the big holding, they are not able to churn out. So yeah, this is a good portfolio. First one, they have put on top the Rosary Biotech due to the COVID-19 condition, and chemical company Navin Fluorine, because chemical demand is right now on top. Yeah, but the work that Quant does, I mean, they have an exceptional research team, and the stocks that they select, these are to the mark. I mean, best in class. Also, just to mention, there are tax saving funds which will save your tax as well as give you returns. So in this category, again, Quant Fund had had the best returns. Okay. And if you see the return of this Quant Tax Fund, it's amazing. So the portfolio would be the same across all the schemes, but this is little less risky. If you see the stocks that it has bought, it's having large caps also. So top holding is ICICI Bank, 7%. So now it has parked the money inside large cap, so that even if the market falls down, your portfolio is buffered. So this month they have 7% allocation to ICICI Bank. Yeah. So ICICI Bank today market crashed, but ICICI Bank did not crash that much. It was in a good shape. Okay. Yeah, it was just 2.2% compared to the Neuland Laboratory that was 10%. So this is the portfolio of Quantex. So I would personally suggest, if you want to create wealth, this is the proof in front of you. There are mutual funds who are doing exceptional work. Do your own research, and simply putting, don't go on the past returns. So next, I would not invest in the portfolio which has given an extremely good returns. And I would also not invest blindly in the equities, because you require a huge amount of time in researching the stocks compared to investing in mutual funds, who are professionals and whose main work is to give the best returns. So yeah, we are getting one question here that how much is the minimum amount? So minimum amount, I think in terms of small cap fund, it's 5,000. And yeah, one more tip I just wanted to give you is just monitor the index. So if you see bscindia.com, just see this index. If index has fallen by 1%, just put in some amount into mutual fund. So daily open the website, open the BSE India and see all these indexes. If you are invested in small cap fund, go to small cap index. And if you see this dropped by 1-2%, just before 12 o'clock, invest some amount into small cap fund. So what happens is you will get the shares value of that particular day, and you will be able to earn more money and buy more stocks because the prices would have dropped on that particular day. Yeah. So that's a tip. And yeah, second question is it advisable to have an FD? Strictly no, because as of now, the FDs are giving returns of 6-7%, which is very, very less compared to the inflation that is rising. So never go for FD as of now. If you are not confident, go for index fund. Let's say Nifty index fund. What index fund does is index fund goes, yeah, here it's a ETF. So what happens is if you have invested in index funds, HDFC Sensex ETF, so if Sensex falls by 1%, your fund falls by 1%. So it's a very safe way to play inside the market, but it's for sure that in long run, let's say 2 years, you will get much more returns compared to your FD. So never go for an FD. Yeah. And one last question we'll take is how do you know if the fund will perform in future? So this is your personal research. Just see the pattern of the fund holdings that the fund manager has done in last 1 or 2 months, and do the research on the stocks, which stocks he has taken and why he has taken. You will be able to get the confidence. And don't just look at the top gainers, also look at the top losers. So let's say if you're looking at small cap fund, 1 year return, we'll see the loser. So the least return has been given by UTI small cap fund. Let's take an example of Axis small cap fund. So the holding this time is Galaxy Surfaced and Tata Elxsi. It's a average holding. So what you can do is you can just look at the losers as well, and you can identify what are the mistakes that this person has done, and is he correcting the mistake? So this is how you can get an idea of the fund in future. So that's it, friends, and we'll meet in the next session. Okay.